Crash Courses. Today's Crash Course is on Microraptors, a four-winged dinosaur from the Cretaceous period. You know, Sandra, it's hard to get a real sense of what these primordial creatures really look like from these simple illustrations. That's why I'm going to visit one in its natural habitat.
That's impossible, sir.
When you say impossible, I hear I'm possible.
What does that even mean?
It means I'm going to travel back in time 120 million years using this untested, homemade time-traveling device.
That's a horrible idea, sir.
Well, time will tell. First, I need to set it. Let's see. I gotta go back 120 million years. One, two, three, four. This might take a while. Go ahead and give today's fast facts. Fact number one. Microraptors have four wings. Some scientists think they use their wings to glide from tree to tree. Number two. Word microraptor comes from the Greek word micro, which means small, and the Latin word raptor, meaning one who seizes or grabs. Crash Courses. Today's Crash Course is on Microraptors, a four-winged dinosaur from the Cretaceous period. You know, Sandra, it's hard to get a real sense of what these primordial creatures really look like from these simple illustrations. That's why I'm going to visit one in its natural habitat.
That's impossible, sir.
When you say impossible, I hear I'm possible.
What does that even mean?
It means I'm going to travel back in time 120 million years using this untested, homemade time-traveling device.
That's a horrible idea, sir.
Well, time will tell. First, I need to set it. Let's see. I gotta go back 120 million years. One, two, three, four. This might take a while. Go ahead and give today's fast facts. Fact number one. Microraptors have four wings. Some scientists think they use their wings to glide from tree to tree. Number two. Word microraptor comes from the Greek word micro, which means small, and the Latin word raptor, meaning one who seizes or grabs. And number three. Microraptors are an example of how dinosaurs were very similar to birds in some ways. Okay, Sandra. I'm ready. Activate the time machine. Okay, I've successfully traveled back in time and jumping Jurassic. Look, a Microraptor live in the flesh. Drats, that earthquake scared it away.
That wasn't an earthquake, sir.
Sandra, you're 120 million years in the future. How could you possibly... Well, that went pretty well.
It went horribly, sir.
Equals
2. Seven minus two. Seven minus seven minus two. Seven minus two equals two. Equals seven. Two. Five. Five plus two. 7 minus 2. 7 minus 2 equals 5. Equals 5. 5. Equals 2. Equals 2. Equals 2. Equals 7. Equals 2. Equals 2. Equals 2. Equals 2. Equals 7. 5 plus 2. 5 plus 2. Equals 7. 7 minus 2. 7 minus 5. Equals 2. Equals 2. 2 plus 5 equals 7. 2 plus 5 equals 7. 7 minus 5 equals 2. 2 plus equals 7 minus 5 mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large, the digestive system.
Snowflakes are probably one of the most common examples of crystals. They form when water in the atmosphere freezes into ice crystals. They can freeze into a variety of shapes and sizes. It is said that no two snowflakes are alike.
Troop 17 to the stage, please.
Next, we have Norman from Troop 17. He'll be trying to earn his bar graph badge. Norman, I will ask all 20 of your fellow scouts the same question. If you can turn their answers into a bar graph in under 2 minutes, you'll earn your bar graph.
Certain types of fish have a sac inside their body called a swim bladder that can help them float or sink in water. These fish can fill their bladder with air to make their bodies become heavier and sink.
Incredible! What rhymes with hat? What rhymes with just? What rhymes with long? What rhymes with man? Nice going! What rhymes with many? Nice going! What rhymes with more?
Awesome job!
What rhymes with old? What rhymes with round?
Awesome!
What rhymes with thank? What rhymes with these? Try again. What rhymes with think? We need fantastic.
Austin and Scout's Word Adventure. Drag word parts to make the word winter. Great job. Winter. Drag word parts to make the word target. Fantastic! Target! Drag word parts to make
I wonder when it's hot out, do their feet burn from the heat? But if they had to cover them, their moms would sing the blues, because they'd have to buy their kids so many pairs of shoes. Bugs and Things. Bugs and Things. It's hard to hold this wiggly, squiggly thing that likes to squirm. I bet you guessed I'm talking about an ooey gooey.
African lion. African lion. Some animals, like sharks and snakes, live alone. But lions live together in family groups, like elephants.
Pendulum. A pendulum is a weight that hangs from a string or rod. If the weight is pushed or drinking bird. A few drops of water on top of the drinking bird's head causes the top bulb to cool. The colder temperature in drinking bird. A few
My Notes on the Founding of Adventure Academy by Clifton Howe. As a young scholar, I learned about the Library of Alexandria. It was the world's single greatest archive of knowledge. Within its walls were humanity's most important works. Then the unthinkable happened. I learned that the library had been destroyed by fire during a civil war. All that knowledge gone forever. Having learned this, my life's mission became clear. I would build a school where people from all over the globe would come and learn. Its location would be as special as the academy itself,
a place where all within the span of a day, students could explore from the highest mountains to the deepest oceans. My travels took me far and wide. I crisscrossed the globe and eventually came upon a tattered map. It detailed a journey to a place like the one I had imagined. Could this be it? As I reached the top of a large mountain, what I saw in the valley below left me speechless. I had found it, the future home of Adventure Academy. I could practically see the school rising up before me. But I could not build the academy alone. If I was to realize my goal, I would need help from the brightest minds around the world. I sent invitations to the brilliant professors Asbert Osworth, Zuki Kato, and Minda Reed. They all accepted and came at once to join me as the founders of Adventure Academy. Filled with determination, we began our work. Together, we planned what would ultimately become Adventure Academy. From the beginning, each of us knew that we would spend the rest of our lives working together to continue building our dream academy.
Thank you.